So this is a preview of the character AI system. So if we move close to the dummy, it's gonna start following us. It's gonna keep following us because we're inside its range. But when we get out its range, it's gonna go back to its spawn point. And if we were to move to the dummy, and if we were to actually kill the dummy, it's gonna clear from the workspace. Since this is its clone, it's gonna come right back to where it was in its original position, so the dummy point. In this video, guys, we're gonna show you guys how to make a character AI system. So first, you wanna import a dummy into the game. So if you were just to look up a dummy inside a toolbox and you get a random dummy right here, you can be able to use this one. Just make sure that it's one of the top ones, because the top ones are the better ones. But since you already have a dummy here, we're just gonna delete this one that we just made. And also, we're gonna have to make a part. We're gonna name a dummy point so we can make the dummy come back to this point if there's nobody inside its range. And now we're gonna start the script. So for this script, we're gonna start off by making it running so we can run away from the humanoid character. So I just made a speed. When you hold X, when you press X, our speed goes to 32, and then we set debounce to true. And if not, if we're gonna go back to regular speed, and it's gonna go back to false. So something simple.
2 plus 2 is 4 minus 1.
And now we're gonna start with our following script. So inside a dummy, we're gonna be defining the two variables, and the primary part is basically just the humanoid root part, so the torso. And we're gonna be defining the humanoid. This is the humanoid inside of the character. So this. And now we're gonna make a function so we can try to call back the character's humanoid root part. Then we're gonna make two more variables called position and distance. So we made position, well, POS short for position. We're gonna make it equal to nil. We're gonna make the distance equal to math.huge. So now instead of looping through the workspace, we're gonna be looping through the characters because it's more efficient that way. So we're gonna do for IV in pairs, game.players get players do. And then we're gonna do if not V, and V is obviously the player. If not V.character, that's the character. If not V.character, that primary part, that's basically the humanoid root part of the model. Then continue N. So we're basically gonna continue. And now we're gonna go back down to here. Now we're gonna make a variable so we can basically get the position between us and the dummy. So now we're gonna get the humanoid root part, the position of the model, minus the position of the character, dot magnitude. So basically primary part is either way the humanoid root part, so you can do it either way. So dot magnitude. Now we're gonna go back down to distance, right? So now we're gonna make our lines true so the dummy doesn't always follow us. So like if we get into its range, it's gonna leave and it's gonna come back at some certain points. So if distance from character, so the distance from the character is less than or equal to the following distance, and the following distance is 15. And if the distance from the character is less than the distance, and we made distance equal to math.huge, and you will understand why we did that, then the position that's equal to nil will be equal to the humanoid root part. So then we're gonna return that, right? And then we're gonna return it. We're gonna return pause, basically position. Well, that's how I call it. And now we're gonna make a while loop. This is what we're gonna do. First, we're gonna get the humanoid root part that we found. So get nearest player. We're gonna get the position as well. And then we're gonna local DP. And DP is the dummy point that we made, so it goes back to that point. So if humanoid root part, then the humanoid that will be the dummy is gonna move to this position, the humanoid root part. Else, if it can't find no humanoid root part, then it's just gonna move back to the dummy point. And then if we go back, now we're gonna make another respawn. So once the dummy dies, it's gonna go back to that certain point. So this is the easiest part of the script. We're gonna define humanoid, character, and clone. So we're gonna clone the character. So every time it dies, we can just clone it and just put it back in the same position. And we're gonna wait for it before it comes back. We're gonna clone it to the workspace and then just destroy the character. And now I'm gonna test it so you guys can see how it works. So basically here, we're gonna press X so we can run faster. Now, as you can see, the dummy's gonna be following us. Now, if we were to kill the dummy, it's gonna spawn back at that point that it was just at. So now we move close to it, it works just like the first time. And if we move out the distance, it goes back to the position that we made. So I'll try to make it more easier for you guys. So we're gonna move as far away as we can, then we're gonna press X. Now it's gonna go back to that original dummy position that we set it to. Now boom, that's basically how you make a character AI system. I'm